Kasaran! Kasaran! Catherine? Catherine! Catherine, where are you? Catherine? 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 Catherine, where are you? You let her go, you bastard!
You broke the rules, Mr. Michaels, and now you will pay the price.
Fine. Do whatever you want with me, but let my wife go. She has nothing to do with this!
On the contrary, Mr. Michaels, she has everything to do with this. She is the reason you're in this mess. All you had to do was keep your mouth shut, and everything would be fine. But if you want to redeem yourself, then pick up the object on the table.
Have it. What do you want me to do?
That is simple, Mr. Michaels. I want you to put a bullet in your brain, or your wife will suffer the same fate.
Fuck.
You have 10 seconds to decide whether your life is worth more than hers.
Hello?
Miranda Dawson. You currently live at 209 Hillview Road.
What the hell is this?
Your average income is $33,000 a year. Currently you're single with no children, but your sister on the other hand is struggling with two kids and a part-time job.
Is this some kind of sick joke? Who the hell are you?
I am the one that can make their life very difficult within several seconds. Unless you do as I say.
What do you want from me?
That is simple. I need you to retrieve some packages for me, and then you won't hear from me again.
Do I have a choice?
No. While you work for me, you will have to follow some very simple rules. Rule 1, you'll have no contact with any member of your family, friends, or acquaintances. Whether that be by phone call, text message, social media, or the homeless network. I will know, and your sister will pay the price. Rule 2, from now on your phone will be left permanently on. You will constantly keep it on you at all times, not to go anywhere you're not supposed to. The failure of just one of these rules will mean bad things for your sister. Do remember, I'm constantly watching you. Every step you take, every word you say, right down to your body language. So you should be careful what you do. I might just take it the wrong way.
I'm at Fremont Drive.
Good. You want Unit 2. The door will be unlocked.
So what is this package I'm looking for?
A silver case. It should be on the floor.
So what happened here?
That belonged to my last agent. He broke the rules, and he paid the ultimate price. I wouldn't if I was you.
What the fuck was that?
That is what happens when one of you fails to follow the rules.
Killed him.
On the contrary, he killed himself to save his wife. So if you don't want your sister to suffer a similar fate, you should get moving. Only another 3 packages to go. Tick tock, Miss Dawson. You don't have all day.
Where to next?
I hear Horseshoe Park's nice this time of year.
I'm at the park.
I know. I can see you. Are you quite finished, Miss Dawson?
Yes, sorry.
Good. Now do you see the gazebo in the center of the park?
Yes, I do.
Good. The package you are looking for is a black hard case, which should be under the chair. Retrieve it, and return to the car. Oh, and Miss Dawson, don't talk to anyone in the park.
have it.
Well done, Miss Dawson. But next time, try to stay a bit more calm. You draw less attention that way.
Where to now?
Go to the cafe on Victoria Street and order yourself a coffee. I'll be in touch.
Hello?
The next package will be delivered by one of my other agents. Look for a man in a suit. He'll be carrying another silver case. Do you see him?
Yeah, I see him.
Good. Now wave him over to the table and retrieve the package. He will do the rest.
Who are you? Are you one of his? Or are you like me? Sorry I asked. Here's the package you wanted.
Well done, Miss Dawson. Three down, one to go. Proceed to the car park on 93rd Broadstone Avenue and wait for instructions. Sorry for the wait, Miss Dawson, but your next contact was a bit late. But he's ready for you now.
So where is he?
Just go down the stairs at the end of the car park, and he'll be waiting for you in the lower parking area. This is very simple. Just grab the case and return to the car, Miss Dawson. Your journey is almost over, so don't screw this up.
Sick of this, Jonathan. Your work is absolutely pathetic, everything that you do.
Hey, no one ever said his courier would look as hot as you.
I was expecting a man in a suit, but hey, I'm not complaining.
Is that the package?
This bad boy? 10 kgs of the finest pharmaceuticals money can buy, pre-packed and ready to go.
I can't do this.
What made you think I'm giving you a choice? You have 20 seconds to start walking before your sister pays the price. So ask yourself, which niece can you live without?
You didn't give me a choice. You threatened my family. But you're almost out of this. So just follow his rules, or you'll end up like me.
You did well, Miss Dawson, but you chose the wrong time to grow a conscience. But no matter, it's all resolved now, and you have the final package.
You had that man killed!
Do you not know who that person was? He was a drug dealer that used to deal drugs not 100 meters away from your niece's school. So you should be thanking me. But no matter.
What about the man in the suit? He committed suicide. Did you order that too?
He broke the rules. And he paid the price. And unless you plan to fall off the train as well, you should quit talking and move on to the last location.
Where am I going?
A small industrial building. The coordinates will follow. Don't screw this up, and I will let you walk.
Fuck! Ah!
Well, Miss Dawson, just as I knew you would. And as I promised, you are free to go.
Really? You're not gonna kill me?
As close as you came, you didn't break any of the rules. And for that, you get to live. And for any inconveniences this may have caused you, I have wire transferred $3.5 million into your account. Tax-free, of course. And as I said, you won't hear from me again. But just one condition. Leave your phone on the table before you leave. It was nice to make your acquaintance, Miranda Dawson. You can leave now. Every day you pour your life into social media. What you like and dislike. Who you're going out with. What family members you are most closest with. What music you enjoy. Your traits, your mistakes, your financial status. All of this is readily available on the internet. To you, it's just words. To someone like me, it's power. Power to control. And there is hundreds of us that will use it to control you. We call it domination. So ask yourself, who will we dominate next?